PTV, Telebisyon ng Bayan.
By addressing once and for all the historical injustices committed upon the Bangsamoro people by the hundreds of years of colonization, we stand strong with the Filipino people in our quest for peace that is just and enduring. Marami pong salamat.
Thank you, Chairman Jafar, and thank you to all the members of the Bangsamoro Transition Commission. Let us now take our seats. To introduce our guest of honor, we request again Secretary Jesus G. Duresa to come up on stage.
Fellow Mindanaoans, fellow Filipinos, the first president from Mindanao of the Republic of the Philippines, Mayor Rodrigo Roa Duterte.
Thank you, Felicito. Pag nagkapirmahan na tayo at mapayapa ng Mindanao, paakyat ako dito. Meantime, on the side lang, ay really, di masyado ako not really ikot ng tayo, but naka-loper ako. Kaya lang, nabasa ako sa Samal, papunta rito. I was attending to a ribbon cutting ceremony for a new drug rehab center. Meron akong speech dito. Lahat naman, every function, meron talaga akong ginagawang speech nila. Pero dalawang pages lang, tapos uwi na tayo. I do not read speeches because does not reflect what is in my heart. Alam mo, when I decided to run, it was because I was a late comer. Nobody was talking about the problems of Mindanao. And what you would hear from the, no offense intended, from the candidate, the usual rigmarole of graft and corruption and infrastructure projects and everything, despite the fact that we are under a threat of war amongst our people. Walang nagsasalita about Mindanao. And every candidate, sinusundan ko sila, nobody really bothered to say that there will be a serious undertaking to solve the problems of Mindanao. So, sabi ko, kung ganito, ano ang mangyari kung puro elitista lang, puro oligarchs, sila-sila lang ang namimili doon ng presidente, at every time, they only protect their own interests, ang newspaper nila publish their own propaganda, ang lahat ng mga TV and networks, eh wala naman kung ginawa kung hindi suportahan yung mga kandidatura ng mga taga-Maynila and every other administration for so long a time never really thought of doing a serious study and come up with a solution sa Mindanao. And among others, I said graft and corruption and itong droga criminality, I said the centerpiece of my candidacy would be the Mindanao issue. So, sinabi ko sa mga Pilipino, alam ninyo, and maybe they'll listen, because ang platform ko, ginagawa ko. When I said there will be no corruption, there will be no corruption. As a matter of fact, I fired last night one taga-Davao na for simply making a remark about sabi ko, he's out. And I told him, even a whiff of corruption, talagang tatanggalin kita. So I'm doing my part. Sa drugs, I am facing so many criticism and even threats of prosecution. And sabi ko, basta gawain ko ang pinangako ko. If I go down, or if I go up, that would be my fortunes or my misfortune sa buhay. Pero I will comply with my promise no matter what. So ito dito ngayon, large part of my campaign, if you were listening, was really about Mindanao and how I explained to the people that Mindanao was already Islam before Magellan arrived here. And that is what the Filipino, the rest, do not understand. Kaya it took somebody with a Marandao descent, but a Christian, to explain to them na ganito ang nangyari sa Mindanao. That before it was the rising of a nationalistic fervor. It had nothing to do about religion. No, hindi yan. But it had to do something about demography and yun, ang sinabi ni ninyo, the colonization of the Philippines. Problema kasi, invade tayo ng other countries. Just like in the Middle East, they are now suffering. They are now in agony as a result of the imperialism of the West. Tayo dito, because it was mishandled and because they insisted dito sa Mindanao first to get the land and to make the people change religion. And it became something like a bad blood because fiercely there was opposition. Ganun ang nangyari. Whatever happened in the past, as we are talking about it now, was just the nationalism of the Moro people and perhaps indigenous tribes here. It had nothing to do with religion. Ito ngayon ang problema ko. Because of the imperialistic tragedy that happened in the Middle East, ngayon ang problema nila is extreme terrorism, extremist. And that is why I am a man in a hurry. Because, sinasabi ko sa inyo, let us avoid extremism. Huwag natin sundin yung mga Arabo kasi tayo Malay. The Malay has always a forgiving heart. Nandyan pa yung ating religion which says, do something good. And that is true for all religions. Ngayon kung papasok sila dito, as they are not attempting to try to inject the IS, mahirap yan. That is why also we must avoid extremism or even entertaining or accommodating them because it will destroy all of us. This will be a country turn apart. Kasi ito sila, walang patawad. And even in the Middle East, because they're driven by insanity, they kill just people for nothing. For no reason at all. Burning women because they do not want to have sex with them, throwing the child into a burning parang bakery ovens, and just simply killing people. Now, if we allow or we allow them to come in here and convert even some, there will be a bloodbath. Sigurado yan because of the mix ng atin dito. Now, I am trying to fast track everything. I promise the Moro people of Mindanao that you will have it during my time in construction. At niwarningan ko, at makikinig naman sila, eh, kasi nanalo ako eh. Sabi ko, pag hindi ninyo sinunod yung payo ko, taga Mindanao, in utter good faith, I'm telling you, that kung hindi ninyo sinunod ang sinasabi ko, magkakaroon talaga tayo ng gulo. And it will never solve your problem. Where else can you find a president na ang lola Maranao? Lolo ko ng Chinese yun. Saan ka makakita dito ng mixture na gano'n? Although, hindi ko pinagbiyayabang yun. Hindi man, naglabas lang yan nung election na kasi naglabasan yung mga cousins ko, yung mga anak kasi. Then it became an open, ano, na ako pala'y dugo ko. Kalahati. One-fourth even. Taga roon. Taga Mindanao. Not only because of blood, because of... Taga rito ako at alam ko yung agony na dinaanan natin. The suffering that we had to undergo. The Christians, the Filipinos, and the Lumad. We must have peace at all costs. But I would like to tell you now that as president, ang gusto ko talagang mangyari na kapayapaan, but it must be one country, one nation, and one flag. Magkaintindihan tayo. So, I am urging the BTC to navigate the hindrances and obstructions at hanapin ninyo ang daan hanggang patungo ng kapayapaan. Mahirap yan. It will be a long journey. But if there is the product that is acceptable to all, makikita ninyo ako, maybe in front of the Filipino nation. I will ask every Filipino to vote for it because it will make us a great nation. So, I leave it up to you. You know the history. You know the equation here. You know the composition of the population. You know the religions here. You know the idiosyncrasies of the tribes. Magkaiba-iba eh. Maski alam ko. Kasi ang lula ko taga rito. I was there. You might not have known it, but in Iligan. Doon sila nakatera. Kasi propiedad-propiedad yan eh. But I used to go to Marawi when I was... And for Dawsi, I was here. Yung kapatid niya, si June, was my best friend. Yun, si June ang nakaalam sa pamilya namin. And I used to go to Marawi during his, when he was still estudyante pa kami sa Ateneo. I used to go to, baka ninyo, napupunta talaga ako ng Marawi when I was young. But I stayed most of the time sa Iligan kasi ang lola ko na palagi sa Iligan, hindi sa Marawi. So, alam ko ang gaano kasakit ang, you know, so sabi ko, I have a daughter who is half Tausog, ang tatay si Sangkula, at si Regia naman sa Maranao. I have yung mga anak ni Pulong, si Omar, si Rodrigo, pati siya. They are devout Muslims. Talagang pious, lalo na yung babae si Isabel. So, kind of really. Mag-usap tayo dito ng tino. Do not events overtake us. Resist. I'm asking you now, resist extremism. Kasi pag extremism, magkagulo tayo. Hindi ko na ma-control yan. pag ang gusto na niyan dito patayan lang, wala namang pag-usapang kapayapaan, talagang gugulo yan. Talagang gugulo yan. And I cannot prevent just say that, not just because they are real, they're just a few. If they start to plunder this island, and then everybody, do not, alam mo, religion is good. Every religion is good. Pero yung extremists in killing people for no reason at all. Medyo ano tayo dyan. Talagang sisirain tayo lahat. Pero kung mayroon ng produkto, and you must hurry. Because if there is, I said, in the third year, mayroon kayong produkto at naipasa ng Congress, we will implement it. And there will be some changes there. And an election for, I advise you, baski na papano, do not forget at this time because of the so many islands and so many political parties and pressures. Sabihin ko na lang sa inyo, most of the people from the zone, guys, they don't understand and they do not want it. So you must, in a newly born to set up, just choose in the meantime, you can do away with the presidency, maybe a pure parliament. But at this time, I would suggest go for the parliament of just like France. Have a good president. Hindi na ako yan. Because if you finish it in 3 to 4 years, there will be an election. And if you provide an office of the president, I will be automatically disqualified. So I will step down. And I would be very happy to see Imara now was a president. Siyempre nauna mo, nabara na mo. Mayan na yung ginda na pati Tauzog. Or I would be happy to say, sino? Iranon. And I would like to see people from the Moro community really, really crafting laws for their own good. It could be a deeper setup than what we others see in other countries. But you have many changes there, and you can follow the best what is really for Mindanao. But it will be a federal type, of course, as I said. And I reiterate again that I would be happy to step down if I say a good law that would govern us all equally. Ang unitary type has worked in this world, not only during the Spaniards, because it provided for an imperial chair, which is Malacañan. Kaya hindi ko tinatawag yung, you have never heard me say Malacañan. I only say my office, my house. Puro ang nagtira dyan, mga imperialista, yung ngayawa na yun. Kaya hindi ako natutulog doon sa kung sino-sino yung mga Amerikano, pati Kachila noon, ay letse. Kung magharap lamang ako ng multo, Pilipino na. Huwag mo ako paharapin imperialista. Mas mag-init ako, imbis matakot pa ako, baka masampal pag ito po. So, ganun. I simply love my country. And I would give way. Well, I will step down. Just come up in a hurry of what is good. Then have an election. We can have the regional, territorial, autonomous regions. And hindi naman happily ever after, but I would be very happy to leave a country that, leave the office and see my country peaceful. Yan lang, madali yan, basta you just put your heart into it. The only appeal that I make, because I only have one country, and that is the Republic of the Philippines. I may only have one. Baski natawagin tayo, ano, you may change one Filipino. Basta tayo, puro tayo Malay. Ang masakit lang sa amin, eh kasi in-invade, nandoon kami sa Visayas ang tatay ko. But luckily, puro yung mother, na itagarito man siya. So, ayan ang ano, that's why there's a bit of diversity. But it is only belief in God. This, the one thing that is really important is that you have the control of the resources and of course the income of your own land. That's what is important to the Moro people, their territory, under the changing fortunes of times in their hands. Yun lang. And I hope that you can, I said, navigate the many obstacles, the many obstructions, but just go right ahead and craft one that is good for the entire Filipino nation. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Mr. President. At this point, may we request the members of the Bangsamoro Transition Commission to join the President for a photo opportunity. And we also request Secretary Duresa, GPH Implementing Panel Chairperson Irene Santiago, and MILF Chairman Alhaj Murad Ibrahim to join the Bangsamoro Transition Commission and the President on stage.